Give it to me!
Don't make me hit you with my pocketbook. Say it again. Oh. Don't make me hit you with my pocketbook. Check this out here. Looking at my body, I bet you're thinking about it. Don't you wanna know how I feel down? Take a number, baby, you ain't the only brother trying to get up under my skirt now.
Fucking all your hot shit, stunting, thinking that you got
to get a
woman.
More like a buzz in my ear.
First, I'm gonna part my hair, and when I part it, I like mine to be at an angle, and I let it fall in my face to see if that's where I want my part to be. So it'll swoop that way. Yeah, that's good. But see, I like to have mine at an angle on the side. I don't know, I think it's more dramatic. It's pretty like that. Don't mind the naps, I know y'all hear them. The reason why I'm showing y'all this is because I don't think I showed in my other tutorials how I did my part. You know, some people want to know from start to finish how to do it. My stocking cap. This is the stocking cap. Move my light so you can see it. This is the stocking cap that I use. Wave cap. It's got the man on it, but you can use a wig cap, but I feel they feel the same for me. And I only use one. It comes with two in a pack. And I only use one. So, this must be for the big head people. I'm trying to count. All right. It does not matter if this part is in front of your head like this, because you're going to cut it. So, I'm just going to leave it like that because it really does not matter. This is the hair that I'll be using. It's the Doobie hair, the premium Doobie, the ultra premium Doobie hair. And it is a number 2. I want it to be brown this time. And you can really pick whatever for the hairstyle that I'm doing. You can actually pick whatever color you want because none of your hair will be showing. Here's some of the styles you can do with the hair on the back. But they say you can use one pack, but I have a big head, as you can see. So I bought 2 packs. This is what it looks like out of the box. Comes on a little cylinder, a little cone cylinder with the cafeteria lady hairnet around it. You just take that off. This is what it looks like. It's naturally curved because of the cylinder. It moves pretty good. It's soft. So this is the hair. I'm going to start laying tracks and I'll come back when I'm about halfway. Alright, I'm going to show you. Remember what I said about laying these front pieces? You're going to want to curve it up so it naturally falls like your real hair. So it gives you, instead of putting it straight on, you want to curve it up just a little bit. Not a huge dramatic curve, but see how it's falling? Can you see that? See how it's falling? Looks like I cut it, but I did it, and it does that even without the dewy hair, with your regular hair, or it makes it easier for you to cut it because it's already at an angle. You see how it's falling at an angle? Yeah. I'm gonna put a couple of pieces in the back, like shorter pieces, because I'm not getting the arch that I want in the back. See how it's going straight? So I'm gonna start putting a couple of tracks, making sure to go along with the line so that the, I should talk to you, huh? So that the hair can lay right, it'll still look layered even though I'm adding extra tracks back there. So, about right here, still curving with the hair that's already there, and I'm gonna add more just to the back, probably just a couple of tracks, just so that I can get that arch that I want in the back and it's not flat back there and just going straight across. It should have more of a arch coming like that. They say you can do your whole head with one pack. Well, Lady B here to tell you, this is all I got left from the first pack. I would have been upset if I would have only bought one. Listen to those people in the chat. Listen to those people in the hair store. Does it move? Unless you start sweating. If you start sweating, it'll start moving. So I suggest you get it cool or have some air blowing on you or something so that you don't start to sweat. But go ahead and put your first track over here for your invisible part. Go ahead and put your first track right here and your first track over here so that it doesn't roll up and start rolling back, so it'll stay in place. I'll show you the finished result. If you want to see how I do my invisible part, go to my other video, my quick weave with the invisible part tutorial, and I'm gonna finish this up. This is the top, and I'm just gonna apply some glue to the back part of the closure. See? And I'm going to put it, excuse me, I'm gonna put it on the top of my head in my little circle. Just push it down. Let's pull this out. I got major bangs right now, so I can't see. And then just play with it to cover up your part. You can't even see me. And then you can just play with it to cover up the remaining tracks. But this is the doobie hair. I like her so far. I haven't cut or anything. It's just flowing like this. Okay, this tutorial, and I'm sorry, I'm not getting the arch. Anyway, I'm gonna put. You can talk, just not so loud, okay? All right. Thank you. love you.